In this video, I will explain how to submit a job that you want to run from a Research Computing login node. This is a non-interactive job that will run in the background. Before logging into a Research Computing resource and running a job, you must set up a Research Computing account, two-factor authentication, and an SSH client application. You must also have obtained an allocation. See our user guide if you need help fulfilling these requirements. Rather than running your job directly, you will write your script and submit it to a batch queuing system called Slurm, which will schedule your job to run non-interactively when resources are available. The script you submit will contain information about the resources required to complete the job. You can write your script in any text editor. Here, we will use the cat command to redirect the script of our test job text into a file. When you submit a job, you will replace test job with a name that will help to identify your job. Now, type #!/bin/bash, go to a new line, and enter your job parameters. Some of these parameters have defaults, so you may not be required to enter them in. However, adding your specific requirements will help your job run in a way that meets your needs most efficiently. This line indicates that this job will run on a single node. This line indicates that this job will run for no longer than 5 minutes. This line specifies the debug quality of service. This line specifies the Haswell partition. Characteristics of the different Summit partitions, as well as the different qualities of service, are available on the Research Computing website. This line indicates that we want to run a single process. Slurm will allocate one CPU core for each process by default. This line indicates your job name. This line indicates that standard output for this job will be directed to a file called testjob.out. Purge all existing modules with the module purge command. Now, enter the commands you want the Research Computing resource to execute. When this job runs, it will write hello to the output, then wait for 30 seconds, then write goodbye. Finish the script by typing EOF and pressing return. Confirm the content of the new testjob.sh script using the cat command. The next step is submitting the job. Load the Slurm module with the command module load slurm/summit. Submit the script to Slurm with the command sbatch testjob.sh. When Slurm accepts a new job, it responds with a job ID number, which can be used to identify the job in the queue. You have now successfully submitted a job. To check the status of the job, type squeue-u$user. This shows the job ID, the partition the job is running on, your username, the status, which will either be R for running, PD for pending, or CG for closing, the length of time the job has been running, the number of nodes, and the name of the node on which the job is running. If you contact rc-help@colorado.edu about your job, reference your job ID number to expedite support. To view the job output, type cat test job dot your job ID number dot out.